Hi all, it's Andy from Solar Reviews again, and today I want to talk about why you should be thinking about going solar in 2021. The first reason, the most obvious perhaps, bill savings. Nobody likes paying a utility bill, and solar in many cases can either eliminate most or all of your electricity bill. The second reason, the federal solar tax credit has been extended until the end of 2022. Meaning that you get 26% of the cost of a solar system back when you do your taxes in the following year. So what that means is if you get your system installed in 2021, when you do your taxes in April, May 2022, you'll get 26% of the cost of the system back in cold hard cash. So that really does make it worthwhile. The other emerging issue, I guess, is grid reliability. More and more of us live in areas where the grid is becoming unstable, mainly because of natural disasters, which are attributable to climate change. Bad storms, big wildfires. We've all seen instances where unusual weather events have caused the grids, the public grid, to be down for significant periods of time. So what's happened over the last couple of years is batteries, energy storage batteries, have become much more competitive, particularly led with Tesla's Powerwall offering, but now there's many other good offerings out there, and in many ways some of them actually have some advantages over the Powerwall. There's offerings from Panasonic, there's offerings from Sonnen, there's offering from energy companies like Enphase and SolarEdge. So there are many offerings now, and so it is realistic for you to get a system now that can give you battery backup when the grid is out. The fourth reason is that solar actually increases the value of your home. Zillow released a study in 2019 that showed on average it increased the value of your home by 4.1%. Now, the funny thing about it is that for the average valued home, that often means that the increase in value you get on your home when you install solar panels on it is actually more than what the system costs. So if you like, it's an instant profit, an instant tax-free gain, if you like. So that's a real reason to consider solar. The other reason, which is an allied reason, is that when you add up both the electricity bill savings you get and also the increase in value of your home, what you actually find often with solar in many parts of the country is that solar is actually a better investment than the long-term returns you've been able to get over the last 50 or 60 years in both residential property and also in the stock market. Now, that won't be true for every year, but solar is a very safe investment because you really, to get the return from it, all you're really relying on is that you'll continue to use power. And the electrification of our economy, the growth in electric cars, means more and more likely in the future that we'll continue to use more and more power. And so getting it from the cheapest source possible, which right now is solar power, makes it make more and more sense. Another factor to consider is that solar panel prices have actually dropped at the wholesale level between 70 and 80% in the last 10 years. And even at the retail level for installed systems, the price drops have been significant, more than 50% in most cases. So what we have now is we have solar systems being able to be installed by really good professional solar companies at a lower cost than they ever have been able to be before. So there are quite good offers around at the moment for installed systems with 10-year labor warranty, 25-year or 30-year panel warranties, 10-year inverter warranties, the whole box and dice, all sorted out for you. There's some really good offers in the range of that $250 to $3 a watt mark. We don't really recommend going below that because that's when you tend to get into the solar companies that tend not to last very long, because they don't really price in what they need to stay in business over a long period of time. But so, lower prices, better investment returns. And one last thing, probably to some the most important thing, is that solar is good for the environment. We always talk about the economics of it because we're all required to think with our hip pockets sometimes. We've all got to make sound financial decisions for our families. And so we tend to think about the economics. But don't forget that these little things are really the planet's answer to global warming. And so any time you get a chance to do something which is an excellent investment and makes our planet better and our future better for us and our children and our grandchildren, I think that's a compelling thing to think about. If you are interested in exploring the economics for your specific home, we have a solar calculator that we'll attach in the comments below this video that allows you to simply put in your address and the amount you spent on your last monthly power bill. And from that, it does everything to analyze the cost and benefits and savings of solar on your particular home. It looks simple at the front end. It takes a minute or so to run the calculator, but it creates a usage profile based on average usage in your area over the time of the day. It creates a seasonal usage pattern for your home. It then compares the solar production output for each hour of the year and maps those two together and really accurately works out how many solar panels you need, how much they'll cost, and how much they'll save you before you even have to decide if you want to speak to a solar company. If you do decide to speak to a solar company, well then that's really where Solar Reviews comes in to help you. We have a network of 800 or so independent, mainly family owned, medium-sized, typically solar companies around America that we absolutely recommend will look after you and make sure that you become a really happy solar customer should you decide to install a system on your home. That's all for now. Have a great day. See you next time.